okay about using my real name only when we weren't in rehearsal?
Thank you. So what do you say?
Okay, stage manager.
There you go.
Could those be any sloppier?
Sorry, stage manager.
Don't be sorry, improve. I didn't get to be where I am today by doing things sloppily. Details, details, details!
Are the water bottles chilled?
I think so.
You think so?
Don't you know?
I put them in the fridge like an hour ago.
Like an hour ago? Could it have been, say, 45 minutes ago?
I guess.
See this face? This is my disappointed face.
Okay, people, let's get this thing started.
Hi, Mr. Henderson.
All right, come on in, come on in, come on in. Everyone, come on in. Just find a seat.
Do you have any chairs?
I don't believe in chairs. Just find a spot on the ground.
Can I have a carpet square at least?
Has this floor been cleaned lately?
That doesn't make any sense. Why do we have to sit on the floor?
Do you want us to sit in order of importance?
Hey, hey, it's just sitting, okay? If we're not able to get you to sit, how am I supposed to do a show? I should just be able to say sit, and you just boom. Actually, you know what? Everybody stand.
What?
I just managed to sit.
He said stand up. How hard is it?
Easy, Julie. Okay, everyone, eyes up here. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Sit. Nope, not good enough.
Oh, come on.
That's it. You will be destroyed.
Easy, Julie. Let's try that again. Everybody stand. And keep standing.
What is your problem?
We are not raising hands now. Fine, what?
I have a medical condition where I'm not really good at following directions.
You have a what?
I have a note from my doctor.
You can't follow directions.
I'm missing an enzyme.
Okay, tell you what, you stand over there.
How come she gets to not follow directions? I don't want to follow directions either!
Sit! Okay, now that we've managed sitting, I think we're ready to move on.
I don't feel like we got the point of the sitting exercise.
He just wants to break us down so we can build back up. It's like the army. I have a boyfriend in the army.
All right, maggots, listen up!
No, Julie, stop.
These pukes make me sick, sir.
We are not in the army. We are doing a musical.
Which requires exact precision, or people die!
No, people aren't going to die.
That's what they said about the Spider-Man musical, and look what happened to them!
Nobody died in that show.
That's not what I heard. I heard that most of the original cast died and were replaced with exact duplicates before opening night.
Can we do Spider-Man?
We are not doing Spider-Man. We are doing Guys and Dolls, okay? Guys and Dolls.
This is one of my favorites.
Thank you, Barry. Julie, can you please talk about the plot real quick? By the way, everyone, this is Julie. She's the stage manager.
Yeah, they know me. My assistant, Deb, is going to set up a slideshow.
See, I've been doing some research on this musical on Wikipedia, and I discovered a few things. First, Deb, can you set up the slideshow, please? What?
There isn't a slideshow?
Well, that's just wonderful, isn't it? Isn't it great that I've done all this research and put all this time and effort into making this multimedia extravaganza, and there's no slideshow? I couldn't have planned it better myself, Deb. So anyway, the musical Guys and Dolls portrays a nightmare world of moral turpitude in which criminal gangs of gamblers compete who can degrade the most into a cesspit of homelessness and alcoholism. Most likely, everyone will die. Thank you.
It's not quite as dark as Julie makes it sound.
Oh, it's awfully dark. I had nightmares for weeks after I read the script. I didn't finish it, but I got to the point where the hero kidnaps the heroine and takes her to the communist country in order to ply her with alcohol.
This show doesn't sound very appropriate for school.
Oh, believe me, it's not.
It's plenty appropriate. Julie, can you please hand out the scripts? Now, everyone, when you get a script, there are rules.
Rules!
Can I highlight my lines?
Can I write a pen?
Can I pull back the cover?
No, 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 you can't touch the script.
Can I burn it?
Can I use that as a lunch tray and then burn it?
We are renting these scripts, okay?
Why? This doesn't make any sense.
That's how it works in musicals. You rent the books and then you give them back.
I want to keep mine.
You can't.
The oil from your fingertips will eat away at the cover, so I want you to wear these gloves when you touch the script.
Write softly in pencil, or better yet, don't write anything at all.
We are watching you. We will know what you have done to these books.
If you have a small role, you don't get a book.
I want a book.
Tough. So let's take the time to introduce our leads. This is Barry, everyone. Barry will be playing the role of Sky Masterson.
Hi, everyone. You probably remember me from last year's production of The Pirates of Penzance. I was the third pirate on the left, and I was tremendous. All the reviews kind of glossed over my performance, but I think if you really looked into the heart of that show...
Thank you, Barry.
Can I just say that I'm a quadruple threat? I mean, acting, check, singing, yeah. I think you can say a check there. Thank you very much. Dancing. Check. And puppetry. I don't have any of my puppets on me right now. But trust me, I'm pretty awesome at puppetry. Okay, fine. I'll give you a little taste if you really want some.
Romeo. Romeo. Where art thou, Romeo?
What's that? Light. Beyond the window breaks.
Romeo, deny thy name and give me a big smooch.
Now let's go down some stairs. Thank you. I think we can all agree that taste was delectable.
Thank you for that.
Stop it.
Barry. And our other male leads. Guy. Guy will be playing the role of Nathan Detroit.
Hey.
Wait a minute. Your name is Guy?
Well, I figured I ought to audition for this show. It's got my name on it.
This is Guy's first musical. He's super excited. Talk to the people a little bit.
Yes. I am super excited.
Great! Have a seat, Guy. And our female leads this year.
Hi, everyone. You know me. I'm Morgan Hill. And I'll be playing the part of Miss Sarah Brown. The second most fun part of the play. Next to the other lead, Adelaide. I don't mind, though, because I love wearing starchy costumes and putting my hair in a bun. Also, awesome, I get to kiss Barry in this show, which is just great. That's totally where I thought my life would be at this point. Not that I'm bitter. I'm not bitter. I can't wait to do this show. But I wanted to do Wicked, which is an incredibly awesome show, and I would have been the best Elphaba ever. Can I just do a bit of my audition song?
I think that's fine.
So watch your eye to find the heavens.
Morgan, you really don't have to do
this. Goodbye, I'm defying gravity, and you can't pull me down.
That was great.
which is just great. Which is awesome! Because instead of flying and using magic, I get to be Miss Sarah Brown, who's working for the Salvation Army! Can you believe that? How much fun it is to work for the Salvation Army and ring that bell. Much more fun than flying and using magic, I can tell you that much. And I think this is the year Barry finally figured out what deodorant was. So that's a bonus. And it looks like some of his pimples are clearing up. Double bonus. I can't wait to do this show. I'm a team player. Can we do Wicked?
The rights to Wicked were not available.
What if we just changed the word to and called it me?
Or that?
That's a stupid name for a musical.
Well, you're a stupid name for a musical.
We ain't doing Guys and Dolls, okay? Guys and Dolls, it's a famous show. They made a movie adaptation with Marlon Brando and Frank Sinatra. Anyone? Marlon Brando and Frank Sinatra?
Were they on The Sopranos?
Moving on. And the last of our leads this year is Angela, who is going to play the role of Adelaide.
The most fun part of the show.
This is also her first musical.
Hey everyone, I'm really excited and I hope I can do a good job.
Can I say something here?
Sure.
On behalf of the cast, I'd really like to welcome you to the musical theater family.
Thanks.
And if you need anything or need any help, don't hesitate to ask. Because Adelaide is a really big part. I mean, it's a pretty scary part, to be honest. If you don't do a great job, the entire show will go up in flames! No pressure or anything. And if you feel that the pressure is too much, I would be happy to take your part for you. I mean, I've done it before. Not your part, but I've been in 3 plays before this, so I kind of think it's my turn to be the lead now. And since you're only, what, a sophomore? You'll get lots of chances to be the lead after this, but I don't have any chances after this. So if you'd like to step down right now, I'd be happy to take your part for you.
I don't want to step down.
Can we vote on this, maybe?
No, we're not voting.
But I just think the rest of the cast should decide who gets to play the part of Adelaide. That would be the fair thing.
Theater isn't fair, Savannah.
My mom is actually on the school board.
That's great, but I don't...
They pay your salary. Okay, show of hands. Who wants me to replace Angelica?
It's Angela.
Whatever her name is.
Raise your hands and I will crush you like bugs. Mr. Henderson decides the cast, okay? No one else gets a say. You think this is a democracy? Ha! This is a dictatorship. We should all respect our fearless leader and never question him. You want freedom of speech? I have a gulag set up in the girls' locker room. You can have all the freedom of speech you want chained up in there. Don't even think about it, Barry. You're not going there.
There will be no passing changes after this point. Okay, everyone?
Fine. Don't blame me if the show is terrible.
Is the show going to be terrible?
I don't want the show to be terrible.
The people who graduated last year were so good.
Hey, stop, okay? It's Guys and Dolls. It's going to be a great show. There's a lot of really fun dancing numbers, and the audience is going to love it. Trust me, Guys and Dolls is famous. All right, everyone, take 5.
Where are all the guys?
Well, Dave graduated last year, and I heard Tom failed math, so it was just me and Guy who auditioned.
And me. I auditioned too. My name's Jim.
What?
Are you kidding me?
Where are the guys?
The show is called Guys and Dolls, not Dolls, Dolls, and Dolls.
Well, there's actually three.
You don't count, Barry.
What if we all wore mustaches?
I have sensitive skin.
Whoa, I'm not going to be a boy in the show. This is for my college audition tapes. Do you understand that? They are not going to see
Where are the guys?
You always make me play the boy because I'm tall. Well, I'm not doing it this time. I'm not a boy, not a boy, not a boy.
Yeah, but you're tall.
I'm not doing it this time. Find someone else to wear a fake beard or to put their hair up in a hat. I want to be pretty. My grandparents won't even recognize me.
Ladies, be quiet.
I have a plan.
You have a plan?
I have a plan. We go to the football team and frame them for crimes. Then we blackmail them into the musical. It doesn't have to be anything major. Kidnapping, arson, assault with a deadly weapon. Something like that.
Why don't you just ask your friends?
I don't have any male associates.
I actually have some friends.
Ask them.
Beg them.
Pay them.
I already did ask them.
The musical?
Are you kidding me?
Dude, I have a life. Almost.
I'm still wearing tights.
I'll do that for Halloween, sure, but not for anything else.
Why won't you leave me alone? Why am I in the musical? I've been told I'm not a very good singer. I mean, it's pretty rare to be told flat out that you can't sing. Most people say things like, you just don't have the notes.
You just need more breath from your diaphragm. You just need confidence.
Pitch.
Tone. Confidence, pitch, and tone. Mostly.
I guess if I had pitch and tone, I'd have confidence. But it's really hard to have confidence when you're at a party and you hear things like this.
What was that? Sounds like Jim's trying to sing.
I'm standing right here.
Oh.
I mean, I'm standing right here and you're talking about me.
Sorry, I didn't know you were there.
I am. Just because you didn't notice me doesn't mean I'm not here.
Lay off, Jim. Jeez, he already apologized. Some people can be so rude.
At least I'm not talking to you behind your back. Let's go.
So I guess I have a pitch, tone, and confidence problem. Also a problem where I can't sing. Like, when I can talk fine. But when I try to sing, I can go for about 4 seconds before I run out of breath and gasp like a dying fish. And I'd like to add that I'm not exactly a spectacular dancer either. Yeah, it's not pretty. So, why am I in the musical? Now, some people might tell you the best reason to be in a musical is because there are at least 2 girls for every guy. At worst, usually, there's 3. But I didn't really care about the numbers. I really cared about them.
Hey, Jim.
Hey.
See ya.
Did you see that? She talked to me! And you know what else? She knows my name, which means she's aware of my existence. I'm already halfway to marriage and kids and retirement. Okay, maybe not quite halfway, but a third of the way. I know that sounds a little obsessive and insane, but I guess that's love, right? Jessica works in the children's section of the library, so I got a job in the other section. Here's the thing. I know that sounds stalkerish, but I feel better on the days that I see Jessica. I'm not even kidding. I feel lighter and sunnier and all around happier, even if I just see her for a second. So I thought to myself, I want to maximize the amount of time that I see Jessica. So I'm gonna try and sing and dance and make a complete fool out of myself. And who knows, maybe she'll feel better on the days that she sees me too. So I'm spreading happiness. I'm gonna tell her how I feel before the end of the musical. I'm terrified to even think about it. I imagine if she would say no, I wouldn't get to see her much anymore. That would be pretty terrible.
Hey everyone, it's Guy here with today's announcements. The school musical Guys and Dolls is just starting rehearsals, and we have a few places out there for some more guys. So if you're sure you're a guy and you want to sing and dance, you don't even really have to sing and dance much in this show. You just wear a suit, look like a gangster, and kinda act like you're shaking some dice. So why don't you come by the auditorium today after school? Oh, and by the way, about half this show takes place in a nightclub where girls are dancing in skimpy outfits. A groovy day, everybody.
I'm here for the show.
Where are the skimpy outfits?
I was told there would be skimpy outfits.
I'm a little embarrassed.
I'm not wearing tights. I'm not wearing tights.
Does anyone mind if I bring my Xbox?
Can I have a different name on the program?
Where are the skimpy outfits?
Greetings, gentlemen. I am Barry. I'll be playing the role of Skye Masterson. That means I'm the lead gangster and I am much cooler than you. The theater's a harsh mistress, my friends. One day she rewards you with fame and notoriety. The next day you injure your foot and have to be replaced.
Ow!
Case in point.
I can still do the show. Don't worry.
So, follow my lead, boys, and you'll have no trouble.
All right, I need the girls out here for the first dance sequence. Can we stay and watch this?
No.
You're not the boss of me.
Let's get one thing straight. I am the boss of
you. You don't look like theater people to me.
And if you so much as breathe the wrong way, I will personally cut you from this show.
Don't think I can't do it.
As stage manager, I have limitless power. Limitless!
So don't cross me.
Now get out of here and go memorize lines!
Yes, ma'am. Hey, Barry, can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, Mr. Henderson. I was just helping out with some of the dance sequences.
I think we'll let Julie handle that one.
No offense, sir, but Julie is drunk with power.
You know, she gets in the way, but she gets the job done. Then, come over here.
What is it?
Let's talk about AP history. You didn't turn in your research project. What happened to that research project?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? This was 2 weeks ago, Barry. You couldn't have told me. The final grades are in.
I don't know what happened to it. I got so busy and then it was late and then I didn't know how to start and then
I could have helped you with that. Angela's in your class. She could have helped you.
I know.
You're one of the leads.
I know.
You're not going to be eligible for this performance. You know, you're really putting us in a difficult spot here. If you could have just told us at auditions that you would have messed up, then it all would be fine. Hey. It's all right. The paper is more important than the players. It's okay.
Can I still come to the rehearsals?
Well, you can't participate.
Just to watch.
Sure.
Thank you. Can I go now?
Yeah.
All right. My assistant Deb is going to help a few of you with the moves here. She's an incredible mover.
I'm a good dancer, too.
You're more of a mover.
Not quite sure what that means.
Don't we have a real choreographer?
Never fear, I'm ready to step in.
I'm the choreographer.
I thought you were the stage manager.
I am the stage manager, slash choreographer, slash dramaturge.
What's that?
Whatever I say is, okay? You just keep your mouth shut and do the moves. Morgan, you're not in this number.
I know. But I've been in dance class since I was 4.
Great!
My character doesn't get the chance to dance, because it's that awesome.
Super!
dance.
Okay. Deb, begin the routine.
All right, everybody. This came to me in a dream. All right? We all dress up like chickens. With feathers and everything. And we let out some high-pitched squeals like, ee! Ee! There you go. And it goes, I love you, a bushel and peck. Strut, 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 peck, 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 like chickens. All right? And we spread bird seed all over the stage. And we eat the bird seed.
We're going to increase.
it, please.
Actors on stage now! Actors on stage now!
Sit! Wow.
I got them whipped into shape, sir.
I'm sure some of you have heard about Barry.
He's dead. It's just like Spider-Man all over again.
He's not dead.
I never liked Barry anyway.
Who's Barry?
Barry failed a class. He won't be able to participate in the show anymore.
Wait, how can Barry fail a class if he's a nerd?
I'll handle this one. There are two kinds of nerds. There are hardworking nerds and lazy nerds.
Lazy nerds are smart. Why, they appear to be smart, but they have no drive whatsoever. They are frequently unorganized and miss assignments. So therefore, you can both be a nerd and not get good grades.
Thank you, Julian. So, we're going to have to find a replacement for Barry.
I'll do it! I get in all the notes he hit. I'll even put on a fake mustache.
Actually, I think we can have Jim do the part.
What?
Sure.
Okay, well, that's it. I'm taking over. This is just like on Star Trek when the captain has gone crazy and the crew needs to revolt. Mr. Henderson has clearly lost his mind. First casting Angela, and now Jim? Where does this end?
I kinda gotta agree with Samantha on this one, Mr. H.
Jim, do you think you can do it?
I guess.
That's all I need to know.
Savannah, shut it. I think he can do it, okay? Can you just relax?
Relax? This is my senior year. This is...
I know what it is. Just relax.
Thanks.
So, Jim, we're going to start up again tomorrow, right?
Does this mean I actually get a script?
Don't write it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Are you ready for the show?
Not even remotely.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Yeah.
Unless we screw up.
Right. But what are the odds of that happening since neither of us has ever had a big part before?
I've never even been in a show before.
I've never even smelled the stage before.
Why would you smell the stage?
Well, it's an expression. Kind of.
Okay, well, I'll talk to you later.
Yeah, don't screw up.
To be honest, I don't know why I'm in the show. It was kind of just a freak decision.
I didn't really give it a lot of thought.
I'm not like a musical theater kind of person, you know? I couldn't tell you what Evita was, and half the time, these people...
No.
I don't get it. How can you sing and pee at the same time?
the show, and...
Wow.
I wanted a small part.
I didn't even want to talk.
Maybe one line.
A grunt.
And now?
The lead.
To be honest, I'm terrified. There, I said it. Petrified, waking up in the middle of the night scared. You know what? I memorized every line in the show. Every single line. I could do the whole play for you right now, even the scenes I'm not in. Because I want to be absolutely sure I don't screw up. There's so much to remember that isn't even mine, though. There's where to walk, how to stand, what to do with your hands. What am I going to do with my hands? Oh, normally, I don't even think about what I'm doing with my hands, but when I'm on stage, there's suddenly these stupid lead balloons on the heads of my wrist, and the only thing I can think to do is cross them over my chest. But, oh, that looks dumb. Oh, what am I going to do with my hands? I used to be a really calm person.
I have this dream pretty often. I'm in the show, and we're about to perform. And I'm backstage waiting to go on when I realize I've been rehearsing for the wrong show. I'm in a completely different play now. I don't know any of my lines. So I think, look at the script. Find some copy of the script. But nobody has one. So I'm just running around in the dark trying to get one look at it before I have to go out there. When time runs out, I have to go out anyway. It was so bright out there, and the other actors, dressed up for Shakespeare, they were looking at me like it was my turn to talk. So what comes out of my mouth? I can't even remember that part. I just know it was bad.
To the mission, so it's not about the money.
Oh, right.
You trick these scumbags into attending a religious meeting, which makes my character, since she's oh so smart, fall in love with you. Very realistic. Not at all like Wicked, in which characters are emotionally developed as a commentary on fascism. No. We dance in the sewers. Not with each other. Now, you may ask the question, if we're tough gangsters, why are we dancing? Gangsters don't normally dance. And my answer to that is, shut up and do the musical, okay? Now, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Slide, twist, twist. Slide, twist, twist. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Spin and pose. Got it?
No.
It's easy. See? Kick, kick, 2 and 3. Kick, kick, 2 and 3. Slide, twist, twist. Slide, twist, twist. Got it?
I'm not doing that.
People laugh at me.
It's a comedy. They're supposed to laugh.
I don't want them to laugh.
Hey, do it now. And Jim, I just want you to walk around and look cool, okay? Ready, guys?
Fountain right here in the middle. Okay? Do I dance in this part?
Don't worry, I'll lead.
Do you guys have your lines memorized?
I got my script yesterday.
Yeah, I'm still processing. Do I have lines?
They're in Spanish.
Can I get a script then?
We'll just improv it. All right, Jim, you're being charming. Morgan, you've had a few too much to drink. And Jesse, you spot him, and you want to own him. Got it? Let's try it.
Oh, Mr. Masterson, you're so funny. Oh, whoopsie! Someone put a slanted thing on this chair. So, tell me.
Drunk?
Well, I've never been drunk before.
Just be dizzy.
It's fine.
And Jim, you can say your lines too.
Can I just... Oh, Mr. Masterson.
Whoa. Isn't Cuba nice?
And the music is going. Wait, stop that. No. You must have hit the wrong song.
My heart is beating so fast. Let's dance, baby.
Okay, Jesse. Go get it. And great! That was awesome! That was really good. Jesse, a little more Latin hip action, okay?
Okay.
And great! That was awesome. Let's get those lines down, okay?
See you, Jim.
Bye. Oh, wait, Jesse, can I hold on to your... For a second?
Sure.
I was wondering if we could run over some lines after school today.
I gotta work at 6, actually.
Oh.
I think you're doing a great job with the show, though.
Really? Because I think I'm terrible.
No, you're really funny. In the way you're supposed to be funny. Not like how Barry was funny. He sounded like Darth Vader.
Yeah, but he did have pitch, tone, and confidence.
You're doing great.
Wait, Jesse. Will you go out with me? Now, if this was a musical, this would be the part where I break out into song. If I got lucky, it'd be duet. Who knows nothing? Only a bird will wander. Only a breeze will sigh. A little knows how easy. Oh, I forgot the rest of it.
Oh, that was really nice.
So, I'm sorry.
No, you're a great guy. You really are. I'm not dating anyone right now. And you're gonna find an amazing girl who adores you for being Jim, alright?
Oh, okay.
And there's gonna be an amazing life for you. I just know it.
Okay.
And besides, once you get to perform as Guy Masterson, every girl in the audience is gonna fall for you. Trust me.
Okay.
I gotta go. You okay?
Yeah. At least I got a hug.
Mr. Henderson.
Oh, Angela! Glad you're here. Let's work on that cold song of yours. Are you alright?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I think maybe Savannah should have my part.
No, hey,
I tell you what I was thinking. She's a really good singer, and I know she really wants the part of Adelaide, and I don't know, I just don't think I'm any good. Before you say anything else, you should have put me up to this. I thought of it on my own.
I believe you. Can I ask you a question? What are you good at?
What do you mean?
I mean, what are you good at?
I don't know. I don't think I'm good at anything.
Nothing?
Well, I get B's in school, so I guess I'm okay. I'm not really an athlete or anything.
You don't think there's anything that makes you special?
No, I guess I'm just average.
Well, let me tell you, I don't think you're good at this. I think you're great at this, and I wouldn't have cast you if I didn't think you could be amazing. And I don't make mistakes. And I didn't make a mistake with you. Do you believe me?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's what I want you to think about when you sing. I want you to look into the audience. Out there right now, every single empty spot in the audience. And those are the people who love Angela. Those are the people who care about her. And there's no one out there. But maybe there's one guy at the way back of the theater, and that's Nathan. And he might be here, he might be not, but he's not close enough yet. And he's not proving it yet that he's not close enough yet. But when you sing, I want you to sing to him, to tell him to come closer. So sing your song to him. Hey, it's all right. I know you're nervous, but just know your audition was amazing. The audience are going to love you, Angela, okay? They're going to love you.
How about Taylor?
Yeah, I'm not doing that.
a different show. We already paid for this show.
We can do Wicked!
We are not doing Wicked. We're going to get the scene.
I think I can be of some assistance.
I thought you were dead!
I am very much alive. Very much. And I think I have the solution to this problem. Just listen to me and don't question anything. All right, Mr. Henderson. Just bear with us. This is going to be incredible. And 3, 2, 1.
Yo, this is a boat to heaven, yo, got the dice, got my hat, got me feeling my flow. And the crazy young lady said,
sit down, you're rocking the boat!
Sit down! Sit down, sit down, sit down!
And the people all said, sit down! Sit down, you're rocking the boat!
And all the people said, sit down! Sit down, you're rocking the boat!
Sit down!
Sit down!
Sit down!
Sit down!
Sit down, you're rocking the boat!
Yo, he's coming to you live from Mission Time.
No!
Sit down!
Can I make a suggestion?
Please.
Why can't one of the gangsters be a girl? I mean, one of them is named Big Julie.
We already have a Big Julie.
Got it, Savannah. One of the guys is actually going to be played by a girl. Now get out of here!
See you soon.
Bye.
Flying monkeys in the sewer scene.
Sure.